Hello and welcome to this live edition of the 9-Yard Line here on WGN News Now. We had intended to originally talk to you about the Bears' loss to the Cowboys, and we'll maybe have a little bit of discussion on that, but some massive news has come up for the Bears today. For the second time in under a week, the team has made a major move, trading linebacker Roquan Smith to the Baltimore Ravens. We are live on Facebook here on WGNTV.com as well, so if you have any comments about the Bears, about Roquan Smith, if you have any thoughts about the trade itself, we'll go ahead and get to that. You go ahead and leave it in the comments there, and we will go ahead and try to feature as many of those as we possibly can. Now, on the show, it's a little bit different than you're used to seeing here on the 9-Yard Line. Also going to have an interview with Jacob Infante of Windy City Gridiron. Now, he's good to talk to because he not only knows about Roquan as a player, but also the return for the Bears as far as draft capital, not only for this trade, but for the one they made with the Eagles for Robert Quinn a little bit ago. Let's just catch you up on what's happened today, right now. Roquan Smith, now reportedly, traded to the Baltimore Ravens. What is the return for Roquan? Well, it is a second-round pick in 2023 and a fifth-round pick in 2023. So the Bears getting two draft picks. For those of you who are big NFL fans, you might remember that Von Miller last year went to the Los Angeles Rams. He went for a second and third. So, again, a pretty decent return for the Bears. I'm curious what you would have to say on Facebook, what you think about that. But, you know, two draft picks, again, for a player who is not under contract for next year. Roquan was one of the best and most productive players during his time here in Chicago. He was a great tackler, also had interceptions. That's his last interception as a Bear that he had against the Patriots. With 83 tackles, he led the team in tackles this year for the team. He had previously led them the previous four seasons. So Roquan, very, very much a productive player. Very disappointing, I know, for a lot of people to see him go. Also disappointing for the fact that he was never able to come to a long-term contract with the Bears or general manager Ryan Poles. You might remember that Roquan held in during training camp. That meant that he went all the meetings, he went to all of the workouts, but did not take part in practice. Eventually, he did come out and say that he was going to, quote-unquote, bet on himself and play on the final year of his rookie contract that he signed with the Bears. That was actually after another holdout. He didn't even appear in Bourbonnais when training camp was there. Roquan ended up signing with the Bears after he was drafted eighth overall in 2018. So again, to recap, Roquan Smith has been traded from the Bears to the Ravens for a second-round pick and a fifth-round pick in the 2023 NFL Draft. Let's go ahead and take a look at some of the statistics for Roquan here in Chicago. As you can see, incredibly productive, 607 tackles. He led the Bears in tackles in 2018, 19, 20, and 21. He was named an NFL All-Pro second-teamer. That was in 2020 and in 2021. He had 16 and a half sacks, 47 tackles for loss, 7 interceptions, as we've mentioned a few times, led the Bears in tackles every single season. Now, yesterday against the Cowboys in a 49-29 defeat at AT&T Stadium in Arlington, it was actually one of Smith's least productive games as a member of the Bears. He only had 5 tackles, and he was kind of hoping for redemption after that bad performance. Here's what he told the media at AT&T Stadium after the Bears gave up 49 points and 422 yards to the Cowboys.
Very frustrating when you think about it, just knowing the guys that we have in the locker room and going out and putting out a performance like that. It's unacceptable. Oh, did a great job today moving the ball, scoring points. Defense, we can never allow anyone to score that many points on us. So it's going to start with us, and always it's always going to start with us and always end with us. And so we have to be better, and it's that simple. We can't let no one run the ball, throw the ball, or do whatever like that, or score that many points on us, period.
Well, that will have to continue without Roquan. He is now gone off to the Ravens for a second-round and fifth-round pick in the 2023 NFL Draft. Want to remind you again on Facebook, seeing some of the comments coming in here. We're taking live comments here on the Roquan Smith trade. Tell me what you think. Do you like? Do you not like it? Are you upset about it? Obviously, two major trades for the Bears midseason is pretty rare. Now, you might be wondering, the other trade, we'll go into that one as well. That would be Robert Quinn. Looks like I don't have the video for that. Robert Quinn last week was traded to the Eagles. He was traded for a fourth-round pick in the 2023 draft. Not maybe a surprise to some because of the fact that Quinn was obviously entering with a big contract for the next next 2 years. And the Eagles, obviously, right now are looking to win a championship. They're the only undefeated team left in the NFL. So the Bears actually made a major move to be able to go ahead and get a draft pick for Quinn. But now you have Quinn, now you have Smith. 9 games remaining for the Bears. It's going to get really interesting to see how things are going to be for the Bears coming up here. Now, we mentioned we're going to have a live guest on this edition of the 9-Yard Line. That is Jacob Infante of Windy City Gridiron. Jacob, how are you today, and what is your just initial reaction to this trade?
I'm doing all right, Larry. I'll admit the first time that I saw this trade, I was admittedly stunned. I thought that it was definitely a possibility, but I didn't think it was going to happen. So to see it happen essentially coming out of nowhere, there wasn't any rumbling necessarily going on today that indicated that Roquan Smith might be on the move. So I think that this was a move that you could argue one way or another if they had to make it, but I can definitely see where Ryan Poles is coming from, making the argument that the linebacker isn't as much of a valuable position in today's NFL, and Roquan wanted a ton of money. But at the same time, it's bittersweet because Roquan is a very talented football player, and he's been very good for Chicago for quite some time. So a little bit of a mixed emotions here, but I think that it just makes this coming off season that much more interesting.
What are the things you'll remember the most about Roquan in a Bears uniform? Obviously, we mentioned before his incredible productivity, but the way he played, what really stood out to you here in about his 4.5 years in Chicago?
I'd have to say athleticism. I think you're looking at a tackler with sideline to sideline range, a guy who's, you know, one of the premier athletes at the linebacker position, one of the fastest guys at the position, one of the most agile, and he progressively improved in coverage over the years. I think that earlier on, we saw flashes of potential. We saw what Georgia in his time there, that he could be really good there. And especially the last 2 years, I think Roquan's been very good in coverage across the middle of the field. Producing in terms of ball production better than most linebackers, and also someone who can rush the passer a little bit, admittedly not great at shedding blocks, but someone who can exploit some of those exotic blitz looks and find the right gap to explode and pounce when the time's right. So I'd have to say, yeah, athleticism, effort, and reliability as a tackler. And this season had a little bit of ups and downs, but I think that in the grand scheme of things, he was still a very good player for the Bears defense this year. And truthfully, you knew what you were getting out of Roquan year in and year out.
Jacob, obviously the future is very much on the mind of just about everybody when it comes to the Bears, knowing that Ryan Poles is really rebuilding this group. Let's just talk about the haul as a whole, including the Robert Quinn trade. What do you think about the return that the Bears are able to get, not only for the defensive end, but for Roquan today?
So I think that the Roquan deal is pretty fair. It's a tad shy of where I had it. I had approximately like an early to mid second round pick, and then the Bears ended up getting a late second round pick and a fifth round pick, which will end up being later too. But it's not too far off from what I was expecting. I know that Brad Spielberger from Pro Football Focus wrote an article over the offseason. He projected a potential trade would be a 2023 second and a 2024 fifth. And it was that second round pick this year and a fifth round pick in 2023. So generally, this is a pretty decent deal for the Bears. I think that it gives them a lot of flexibility, especially having two second round picks and their own first round pick. It really gives them a lot of potential to upgrade their roster if they want to, you know, make some trades. There are a couple wide receivers who could be dealt over the offseason, and I think that the Bears could most certainly, they have a lot of different options really that they can use. And as far as Robert Quinn goes, I feel like a fourth rounder is probably the best you were going to get for him at this point. Could he have gotten a little bit more in a trade if you traded him earlier in the season or in the offseason? Maybe. You can definitely make that argument coming off of the great year. But in the grand scheme of things, I think a fourth-round pick isn't a bad haul for him at all, considering he's, you know, over 30, he's in the tail end of his career, and he's making a good amount of money. The Bears needed to eat some of that money in order to boost it up to a fourth-round pick. But Robert Quinn's going to be a free agent because of how the Eagles adjusted his deal. Roquan's going to be a free agent at the end of this year, unless the Ravens choose to extend him this year. So for guys that probably weren't going to be on the roster anyway, I think that this is a pretty good haul in the grand scheme of things for Poles and the Bears.
Jacob, for Windy City Gridiron, you do a lot of writing about the NFL draft, about what the Bears may or may not do. Taking a look at the roster now, there's still 9 games left. Where are some of the needs you believe the Bears could focus on come the draft, especially now having more draft capital after these 2 deals?
So the big one that a lot of you are going to hear over the course of the offseason is wide receiver. And that's been a storyline over the course of the year, over the offseason this year, was that Justin Fields doesn't have a ton of great weapons to throw to. And I think that the promise that we're seeing with Justin Fields right now, with a wide receiver room that doesn't have a lot of investment compared to the rest of the league, I think it's definitely encouraging, but you want to give him an opportunity to throw to a true wide receiver one. And I think that whether that's through trade, whether that's through the draft, I think they're going to target wide receiver heavily. And then I like to see a lot of investment through the trenches. So offensive and defensive line. Where the offensive line's at right now, it's a lot of young pieces, a handful of question marks, I guess you could say. Like, there are some guys on there with legit potential. I think Tevin Jenkins has done a very good job at right guard, and we've seen flashes at tackle from Braxton Jones. But, you know, all that said, there's still a little bit of uncertainty up front. I think they'll add value, whether that's at tackle, guard, or center, along the offensive line. And the defensive line it's a bit of a weakness for the Bears now, especially that you've traded Robert Quinn. It's a young, unproven group of edge rushers, and they haven't necessarily done a great job of getting consistent pressure. And I like to see them invest a little bit at D tackle too, because Matt Eberflus has said that, you know, the 3 technique is a very important position, 3 technique defensive tackle, that specific alignment for his scheme. So I'd like to see some defensive line investment, but I think offense is going to be the main focus of this upcoming offseason.
Jacob Infante, Windy City Gridiron. Jacob, thank you very much for your time here on the 9-Yard Line, breaking down the Roquan Smith trade, which has happened here in the last hour. Appreciate it.
Of course. Thank you, Larry.
All right, let's go ahead and talk a little bit about the Bears game yesterday. Obviously, we're talking a little bit about this trade of Roquan Smith this afternoon, but usually here on the 9-Yard Line, we go ahead and recap the Bears game that happened on Sunday. We usually do that here on Monday. Want to remind you one more time, we're taking live comments on what you think of the Roquan Smith deal. Do you like it? Do you not like it? Are you tired of the Bears giving away a lot of players? Are you happy the Bears are giving away some of their better defenders so that they may build for the future? We'd love to hear from you on Facebook, so if you have the chance, go ahead and go to our Facebook, leave a comment. We may share it here in a couple of minutes. But let's go ahead and take a look at the Bears game yesterday. And it was all about defensive struggles, oddly enough, after the Bears traded Quinn to the Eagles on Wednesday. They allowed 422 yards to the Cowboys, who scored on their first 4 possessions and then ran away with it in the second half. Despite another great offensive performance, Justin Fields solid through the air and on the ground, it was simply not enough for the Bears defense, who continues to struggle against the run here in 2022. They allowed 200 yards even and in the 49-29 loss. So the biggest question is for Matt Eberflus, a defensive-minded head coach. What exactly do you do to fix all these defensive problems? Well, here's what he said after the game yesterday.
I would just say being able to get guys, get them in third and longers, you know, so the first and second down defense has got to be better to get us into the third down situations that we like. Got to look at every play for it, one play at a time, and look at it. And then say, okay, hey, this was good, this was the breakdown, this is how we improve. That's it. That's what you got to do.
Now, right now in the NFC North Division, pretty much it's all about one team, the Minnesota Vikings. They beat the Cardinals on Sunday afternoon, so they are running away with the division right now. The Bears and the Packers are actually tied for second place. Because the Packers beat the Bears, they would have the tiebreaker, but Detroit is 1-6, and the Packers are really struggling. Detroit is really struggling. The Vikings are really the only team right now that's doing really good or really getting anything going, and frankly, they may run away with the division. Green Bay is struggling at the moment. You never know with Aaron Rodgers. Things could certainly turn around, but the Bears' hopes certainly taking a little bit of a hit. As many people expected, you thought Roquan Smith might be traded before the season. He did request a trade back then kind of backed off of it in training camp. But here we go. Let's go ahead right now on the 9-Yard Line, recap what has happened today. Roquan Smith reportedly traded to the Ravens. It's not official from either team as of yet. And in exchange, the Bears get a second-round pick in 2023, along with a fifth-round pick in 2023. Smith was leading the Bears this season with 83 tackles. He also had a pair of interceptions, though against the Cowboys on Sunday, he had one of his least productive games as a member of the Bears, as he only made 5 tackles on the afternoon. And as you can see, Roquan was incredibly productive during his time here in Chicago. 607 tackles, 16 and a half sacks, 47 tackles for loss with 7 interceptions, leading the Bears in tackles every season. He was an NFL second team All-Pro in 2020 and 2021. We mentioned before that this is the second major trade for the Bears just over the last few days. Robert Quinn was traded to the Eagles last Wednesday in exchange for a 2023 fourth-round pick. So the Bears getting great draft capital here over the past couple of days. 3 picks. They get the fourth rounder for Robert, and then for Roquan, they get the second and the fifth. So now I'm going to take some comments from Facebook from those of you who have gone ahead and made a comment. We appreciate those who have tuned into this very special edition. C, you are a common commenter here on the 9-Yard Line. Oh, looks like we're having some trouble getting the comments right now. Looks like they're not working at the moment. But C, I see that you were saying Ryan Poles trying to lose. He can get a top 3 spot in the draft, trade down, trade up, acquire more picks. We'll see if that ends up happening. Tom says that this is the Bears version of the Cubs sell-off. Rebuild to nowhere? I don't know. It's interesting in the NFL because you don't really have a lot of time when it comes to a rebuild. C mentioning that the Roquan did request a trade, couldn't become the highest paid linebacker. The Bears felt like they always had a great offer for him, but they never really got what they were really hoping for. So we'll see exactly what happens with that. If the Bears can, really turn those into some great players. Draft times, it works sometimes, it doesn't others. So going down the list here, going to try to see if I can get these comments to work. Looks like we're having a little bit of a problem with our system. In fact, you know what, I'm going to actually try something real quick. I wonder if this might go ahead and work. And I'm going to make a quick adjustment here. Let me see if this works. Cheryl, very simple. Actually, we got them all to work now. Perfect. Cheryl not liking the trade. I've seen that on here a lot. Roquan, a very popular and productive member of the Bears. I would say, I think pretty fair to say he was the best draft pick of the Ryan Pace era. Incredibly productive, really good, and really good. Fred, I see you there. Are they stupid? There's a lot of people who are really upset about this. Jonathan chiming in here. Typical Bears trading away their best defensive player for a second rounder. Would have been really cool to see them get a first round pick. The only problem is there's no team control, so the Ravens could or could not sign him. So being able to give away a first might not have been something they want to do. Jonathan, thank you very much for watching the show. I do appreciate it. C, we'll go ahead and I'll show you one of his. I was saying that before we couldn't get it to work. Roquan did request to be traded at the beginning of the season after he couldn't be the highest paid linebacker. Again, held in during training camp, due to the new CBA, holding in is actually something players do because if they hold out, it actually, costs them. They can be fined heavily. So Roquan was holding in, which means he basically did everything except for practice. And then he was finally able to go ahead and do that. Tom, going to share your comment. I wrote it. I read it before. The Bears version of the Cubs sell-off, rebuild to nowhere. We will see what the Cubs become. I'm very curious to see what they're going to do in this offseason. That will be for another live stream and perhaps for another day. Dave coming in here with what I think is a pretty popular opinion from some Bears fans. Should have gotten a first-round pick. Very well could have, but I think if the Bears had any kind of contract control, perhaps maybe with 1 year on it, maybe they could have possibly done it. But again, no guaranteed contract control unless they were able to get a deal beforehand. You might remember that when the Bears traded for Khalil Mack, that was for 2 first-round picks, but they were going to sign him to a deal, so a little bit of a different situation. Dennis coming in here. Looks like Dennis approves the trade. Says it's a no-brainer. In many ways, it is, because you don't know if Roquan was going to resign. You don't know if him and Ryan Poles could kind of iron things out. After what seemed like a pretty tenuous negotiation, another thing to remember about Roquan, he was representing himself, no agent, when it came to negotiating with Poles during training camp, trying to get that new deal, which, of course, never happened. And, of course, now he is going somewhere else. I have a few more seconds here if you have anything to say. How about Tina coming in here? Tina, with a little faith here in Ryan Poles. Wow, not Roquan, but I'm going to trust the process. It is certainly a process. The Bears getting three draft picks here just over the last week in exchange for their two best defensive players. Let's go ahead and finish it out with C, a loyal viewer of the 9-yard line here on WGN News Now, mentioning something very, very specific. Justin Fields played a very good game yesterday. It certainly seems like he's found a little bit more rhythm as Ryan Getsy has adjusted the offense to fit him and what he does best. A lot of that is running, some design runs. The Bears' offense has been pretty good, 33 and 29 points, not too bad. We'll see how they can follow that up. The Bears may need to score some more points if they want to be competitive here in the final part of the season. You usually don't hear that, but the Bears' defense obviously taking major hits today with Roquan Smith being traded for a second and a fifth rounder in 2023, and of course Robert Quinn getting traded to the Eagles about a week ago. Well, that's going to wrap up this special edition of the 9-Yard Line as we talk about the Roquan Smith trade. So happy to Jacob Infante of Windy City Gridiron for joining me on very, very short notice here on WGN News Now. As we've said before, we always have the 9-Yard Line here on our program. We do so Monday and Friday. Sometimes we go live, sometimes we tape it, but we always have it up on the sports page of WGNTV.com. But for right now, I'm Larry Hawley, and have yourself a wonderful afternoon. And check for updates on the Bears' Roquan Smith trade at WGNTV.com. Have a wonderful day.